To run a C program, we need two things. First, we need an application to write our C program. It can be simple as Notepad, or you can use a dedicated code editor like VS Code Editor. And then compiler. You may think, what is compiler? It is a program that will translate our C code to machine code so that we can run our C program. So, in this video, what we will be doing is we will be installing VS Code for writing our code and MinGW64 for compiling our code. So, let's begin. For that, first open any browser and then simply search for VS Code to download VS Code. Here, in search result, click on this download button to directly go to the download page. And now here, since we are on Windows, simply click on this Windows button to start downloading VS Code. You will be redirected to this Getting Started page and you will see thanks for downloading VS Code. That means your downloading has started. Now the next thing is compiler. We need to download a compiler. So for this, on this page, see this is overview, go down and you will see C++. Here click on this link, that is GCC on Windows. And then you will get this page using GCC with MinGW. Here all you have to do is to scroll down a little bit. And on this third point, you will see this MSys2. So click on it and you will be redirected to the MSys2 website. We will be using MSys2 to download ourselves a compiler. So here first download MSys2. So click here in installation section. The first point is download the installer. So click on it and your downloading will start. As you can see here, both of these things are downloading, VS Code and MSys2. So just wait for them to be completed. The VS Code is successfully downloaded. So simply open the setup by clicking on it. And then you need to install it like you install every other application in your Windows PC. See, I accept the agreements. Next, next, the location, if you want to change, you can change it. And then here, all you have to do is to make sure you click on this add open with code icon. And also if you want to create, create a desktop icon and your installing will start. The open with code will help us to open VS Code in any directory that we want. I will show you that later. And now, as you can see, the installation is almost completed. And it is done. So we won't launch our VS Code right now. First, we will install our MinGW64 using this MSys2 installer. So it is also downloaded now. So click on it to open it. Installing this will be simple as installing VS Code. Just keep clicking on next button. But make sure to remember this installation folder that we are going to need later. And then just keep click on next. And here it is, installing MSys64-bit. This installation will take 5 to 10 minutes to complete. For me, it took like approximately 10 minutes. And then after it is completed, make sure this button is checked, that is run my MySys264-bit. By default, it is already ticked. So click on finish button and your MySys264-bit will run now. So just wait for it. It will take some time to run. As you can see here, it is MSys264-bit. Now you need to enter one command here to install MinGW64. See here in MSys2 page on 6th point, you will find this command, that is pacman-s-mingw64. So copy that command and here on this terminal, paste it here. And this will download MinGW64 for you, the latest version. Let me tell you one more time how to get that code. See here on VS Code page, you will get the address for MSys2 website. Or you can simply type it, that is msys2.org. And you will scroll down on getting started section. On 6th point, there is the command, that is pacman-s-mingw64. Or you can simply type that exact command from this video. So after you enter that command, you will require internet access. So make sure you have internet access. And it will download MinGW64 for us. As you can see here, the total download size is 55.92 MB. Proceed with installation. So here all you have to do is to enter Y to proceed with installation. After installation, the size will be 392.73 MB. So just enter Y and it will download MinGW64. As you can see here, it will take some time to download it. And after it is downloaded, what it will do is it will verify it. So let me just show you. See, only one last file is remaining. See, it is completed. Now it is checking the integrity of these packages that have been downloaded right now, that is from the official source or not, and after that it will install them automatically. So all you have to do here is to just wait. It will take 5 to 10 minutes to complete. As you can see here, installing, and it is completed. Now simply close this terminal, and now we need to add a path of our MinGW64 so that our computer will know where it is located. So for that, get inside msys64 folder, and you will see this folder in your local disk C if you have not changed your default installation folder. Here you need to find another folder named MinGW64. Here it is, click on it, and then click on this bin folder. All you have to do here now is to copy this address from the address bar. So just simply copy it. And now we need to add this path to our environment variables. So for that, right click on your disk PC and then click on properties. And this will open your settings. And here all you have to do is to click on this advanced system settings and then click on this button, environment variables. Here click on this path and then click on edit. Simple. Maybe this will be empty for you. Here all you have to do is to click on this new button and then paste the address that you have copied, and then click on OK button, OK and OK, and you have successfully done it. Let me tell you one more time. This PC, properties, and from properties you have to click on this advanced system settings, then environment variables, then select path, and then click on edit and add your path here. Make sure to correctly do this, or else you won't be able to compile your C programs. To make sure you have done everything correctly, open your command prompt and here type GCC, this three letters GCC, and if you get this error, fatal error, no input files, that means you have done it correctly. You can check your GCC version by typing gcc --version. As you can see here, this is our version right now. Now that everything is installed, we are ready to open our VS Code. I will open it in a folder where I will be storing all the programs from this series. So just right click on any folder that you want to open and then show more options, and you will see open with code option to open VS Code in that folder. It will take little time to open cause I am recording right now and I had to uninstall my VS Code and install it again for you guys. So here if you get this option, just click on yes, I trust this author, and then maximize your VS Code. And here if you want to change theme, you can change it, or you can complete all these steps that are given here in getting started section, or you can simply close it. This is the file explorer section. By clicking on any file, you will simply open it, or you can click on this button to create a new file and this button to create a new folder in your current directory. As you may see here, we got one notification from VS Code that do you want to install recommended extensions for C? So I will recommend you to simply click on install button to install them, or you can click on show to show them. So from all these recommended extensions, all you need is this one. The first one, that is C or C++ IntelliSense, that will help you in writing your code. But if you want to install all of them, simply click on install button to install everything. You should only install the first extension that will help you in writing code, but I'm going to install all of them. So if you want to do that too, but it will take some time and data. They have been successfully installed, every one of them. Now the next extension I would recommend you to install is, first let me show you how to get to this extension section. See, this is the file explorer, and at last there is extensions. Here you can search for any extension that you want. So search for code runner. This will help you in running and compiling your C code. This is the extension that I am talking about. Simply click on install button to install it, and it won't take that much time. As you can see here, installing and then installed. So now that we have installed everything, now let's try to run our C program, and I will tell you why we need code runner. This is the basic program that will print hello world in our terminal. To run it, click here on drop down and select run code. You need to do it for the first time. After that, you can click on that triangle button to run it. Here, as you can see, hello world is printed in our terminal. You can run that program again by simply just clicking on triangle button this time. And so what does code runner do is that first it compiles our program and then automatically runs it. You can see that command to compiling and running our program in this output section. As you can see here, gcc hello.c and then ./hello, and then we got our hello world program. So it is done automatically. Now let me show you how it is done manually. See, if you will open your terminal, and the first thing you need to do is to compile your program to create a .exe file. So for that you need to type, see, this is our hello.c file. So for that you need to type gcc hello.c. We need to compile this C file, and then -o for the output file, and you can name it anything you want. For example, hello1.exe. This command will compile our source code to a new file name, that is hello1.exe. And now you can run that hello1.exe by typing ./hello1.exe, and you will see hello world printed in your terminal. So all this process of compiling and running your program is automatically done by code runner, so that you don't have to type those commands every time. That is why I will recommend you code runner. This is how you can run C programs in Windows with the help of VS Code and MinGW compiler. That's it for this video. Don't forget to drop a like and comment for the YouTube algorithm, so that YouTube will recommend this video to more people. I will see you in next one.